This is Comac C919, China's first homegrown narrow-body jet that's been in the works for more than a decade. This is a 737 MAX 8, Boeing's popular narrow-body plane among airlines worldwide. This type of plane can cover lots of domestic and intercontinental routes, accounting for more than half of the global passenger aircraft fleet. And that's a big reason why Beijing hopes its own model can compete with Western giants like Boeing and become the main carrier at home, eventually one day taking on the global airspace. So we compare the design and technology of both planes to see how China's deep reliance on Western parts could stymie Beijing's ambition to challenge its US rival. Boeing has more than 100 years of experience with commercial aviation. China, in comparison, started exploring the industry in the 1970s, but for several decades wasn't able to develop its own airliner. So Boeing became one of China's go-to companies.
In China, Boeing has had a great couple decades.
Richard Abulafia is managing director with Aerodynamic Advisory, an aerospace and defense consultancy based in Michigan. For more than 30 years, he's been tracking global aviation markets with Boeing as one of his main focuses.
If you look back at China economic growth and air travel demand growth, it really took off in the 90s. And sometime in the 2000s, that began to translate into very large jetliner sales numbers.
Boeing's jetliner sales hit a record high in 2017. The American giant sent more than 200 planes to China. That's about a quarter of all its deliveries that year. It also has a 737 completion and delivery plant there. Today, about 40% of China's passenger fleet comes from Boeing, with more than half of the planes held by the European giant Airbus, which also has an assembly plant in China. So in order to reduce its reliance on the two Western jetliners, the Chinese government has been focused on Comac, which was established in 2008, and Chinese President Xi Jinping has especially been keen on creating a domestic airliner. China hasn't revealed how much it's invested in Comac, but some aerospace analysts estimate that the state-owned company has received somewhere between $49 and $72 billion in government aid.
That was and is a national goal for China to be able to compete against the U.S. and Boeing.
Alex Kreutz is managing director with U.S.-based aerospace consulting firm Patriot Industrial Partners, and he's been following Comac's programs for about 7 years.
Ultimately, designing and building a successful commercial airliner is very technologically advanced for countries to be able to do.
So to develop a successful commercial airliner, China has been eyeing Western designs like Boeing. The two jets are both narrow bodies with a single aisle. They're also about the same size and carry a similar number of passengers. Even the engines aren't too different.
They're from CFM, which is a joint venture between General Electric and Safran of France. And they're very similar engines with roughly similar levels of technology.
Both engines are models from the Leap 1 series from CFM.
Leap 1B is for Boeing, Leap 1C is for Comac.
But the MAX 8 and the C919 need more than just the engines to take off.
They need other systems like the mechanical systems, landing gears, air management systems, avionics for the cockpits.
These components and their supply chains have played a big role in establishing Boeing as an industry leader over the years. With decades of experience, the American company has developed steady relationships with its partners and suppliers at home and abroad, and most of them are close allies of the U.S.
It's very much an international creation. Boeing's major international partner is Japan, Britain, France, Canada, Italy, Germany, and many others.
Those partnerships have helped Boeing secure some of the most advanced technologies for its aircraft, like the cockpit, which is the brain of the plane. Comac also needs a global supply chain to put the C919 together, especially from American and European companies. But aerospace analysts say some foreign suppliers have been reluctant to provide state-of-the-art components over concerns about their intellectual property. This has saddled the C919 with older technology than the 737 MAX 8 and even the Airbus 320neo. But this may not be the biggest risk to the Comac project.
There's this, I guess, sword hanging over the 919, and a lot of it does come down to geopolitics.
The U.S. has long accused China of seeking to steal advanced technologies for use in its military, which Beijing repeatedly denied. In January last year, the Trump administration added Comac to a list of companies that it said supported China's military, curbing the plane manufacturer's access to American technology and funding. Comac was later removed when President Biden issued a new list. The Chinese company didn't respond to a request for comment about the blacklist and concerns over IP infringement, as well as whether geopolitical tensions could pose a risk to its C919 program. Even if these vulnerabilities with sourcing critical Western parts disappeared, aviation experts say Comac still has other challenges.
Learning how to build it conforming, that is to say, each article is exactly the same as the previous one, that's a major challenge. That's one of the easiest places to stumble.
And another stumbling block, if and when China goes global, the lack of a worldwide support system for operators to obtain C919 spare parts or receive maintenance and repairs.
You have to service it, aftermarket support for the airplanes. So there's vast networks that Boeing has that Comac has to develop.
For Boeing, the U.S. giant also has its own problems, especially in the Chinese market. As trade tensions broke out between the U.S. and China in 2017, Beijing froze nearly all orders and deliveries of Boeing's planes. Since early 2019, the country has also kept the 737 MAX grounded after two fatal crashes in Indonesia and Ethiopia. Boeing says it continues to work with global regulators and customers to safely return the 737 MAX and sees China as an important market for the company's commercial planes, urging dialogue between Beijing and Washington. Despite the challenges, Comac is moving forward. The C919 marked a major milestone in September towards carrying passengers, and the company has plans to develop a wide-body plane as well. But for Comac to rival Boeing, it'll be a long and perhaps bumpy flight ahead.